to all. I'm Mani, an assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Dr. NGP Mishra. So in this class, I'm going to take the lecture about water jet machining. So before we get into the working principle of this water jet machining, we shall discuss the each and every components in the water jet machining. So the major components in the water jet machining are reservoir, pump, intensifier, accumulator, control valve, flow regulator, nozzle. So these are the major components. Now we can see the working of the function of the each and every component. First one is the reservoir. So reservoir is used for mainly to store the water, which is to be used in the used to remove the workpiece. The next one is the pump, which is used to pump the water from the reservoir. Then intensifier. Intensifier is used to pressurize the water for our required pressure. Normally the pressure intensifier ranges from 200 to 400 megapascals in the intensifier. Then accumulator is a temporary storage for the pressurized water. Then from the accumulator, the water is flows through the control valve. The control valve is used to control the flow of water. Then flow regulator, which controls the flow of water. Then this flow of water passes through the nozzle. Here the nozzle is attached here. So the main function of nozzle is, which is used to increase the kinetic energy of the water. So the kinetic energy, now we can see the working. So kinetic energy of the water is flowing from reservoir, which strikes the workpiece. The mechanical energy is here, the pressurized water energy is converted into the mechanical energy. So which impinges on the workpiece, it removes the workpiece. The main point we have to note on is here the stress is created, more stress will be created in the workpiece, which removes the unwanted material in the workpiece. The main advantages or main applications, this type of machining is used for only the soft materials, and also the accuracy is also high in the water jet machine.